Hi, I'm Chuck, and this is Matt. We're here to take you on a tour of the Alliance Station, including features that are unique to FIRST STEAMWORKS. The most obvious difference is that the Alliance Station is smaller than in previous years. It is surrounded by the opponent's loading lane, so it's only 22 feet 4 inches wide by 8 foot 9 inches deep. You'll notice that there's a panel called a loading station between two of the player stations. If you're on the Red Alliance, it's between stations 1 and 2. If you're on the Blue Alliance, it's between stations 2 and 3. This is where your human player feeds fuel from your overflow bin back onto the field. You should watch out for any loose fuel on the floor. If this happens, we recommend you put it in your overflow bin or back onto the field via the loading station. JB and Jamie give more information about bins and how to use a loading station in their video, Loading Lanes.
The overflow bin is staged here, next to the boiler. If your opponent's bin overflows or isn't there, scored fuel ends up in your bin. It can be removed to transport fuel over to your loading station. Each player station has a shelf for an operator console. Note the strip of 2-inch wide hook and loop tape, loop side up. Each player station has an Ethernet cable which connects the operator console's computer to the field management system. The e-stop button on the shelf lets you disable your robot if necessary. There's an AC outlet for your operator console with a 2-amp fuse. If you find yourself in the middle player station, watch out for the equipment under the shelf.
Notice the stack lights above each player station. They relay information to the field crew for quick diagnostics. The bottom amber light indicates that your robot has been e-stopped. The top two lights match the Alliance color. If they are off, it's before the match and the robot is linked, but disabled because the match hasn't started yet. If the lights are flashing slowly before the match, once per second, it means that your robot has not yet linked to your driver's station. If your robot loses connectivity with the driver's station during the match, the lights will begin to flash again until connectivity is reestablished. If they are on, the robot is connected and enabled. You only see this state during a match. Each player station has a team sign that displays their team number throughout the match. The official time remaining in the match is displayed on signs hung from the top of each double loading station, which are identified with a white strip of tape. Don't forget to bring your banner to the field with you. Above your team sign is a holder for your standard. Make sure to place it securely so that it doesn't become dislodged during the match.
Above the wall, you'll notice the steam pipe. It starts at the boiler, runs across the top of the wall to the midpoint where it turns towards the airship. The steam pipe has lights that chase through it to indicate that steam is flowing from the boiler to the steam tank. Two more things. The starting line is 2.5 feet away from the Alliance wall. Operators must stay behind it during auto. Visibility will be tricky this year, as large airships obscure parts of the field.